Lordstown Motors. At one point, the company was racing to build America's first all-electric pickup.
They make them in Lordstown, Ohio. I heard the sales are great.
It had a design for a truck, a factory to make it in, and hundreds of millions of dollars in investment.
But then, the wheels fell off Lordstown Motors.
Its share price plummeted, its namesake factory was sold off, and now the future of its pickup, the Endurance, is in question.
So, what exactly happened to Lordstown Motors?
Our story starts, somewhat unsurprisingly, here. Lordstown, Ohio, 2019. General Motors had been making the Chevrolet Cruze here for years, but a drop in sales led to the company wanting to close the plant, which led to protests and drew criticism from then-President Donald Trump.
What's going on with General Motors? Get that plant open or sell it to somebody and they'll open it.
GM did just that. They gave a new EV startup a $40 million loan to buy the plant, complete with machinery, for $20 million. The startup would be named after the neighborhood itself, Lordstown Motors. Its founder was the former chief executive of another fledgling automotive startup called Workhorse, a man named Steve Burns.
We think we're going to do the impossible here.
Burns licensed a vehicle design from his former company, Workhorse, and set about entering the race to build the first EV pickup. And remember, this is before Ford's F-150 Lightning or Rivian's R1T had been released.
Our first vehicle is the Endurance all-electric pickup truck.
Armed with a factory and a design for a truck, all the company needed now was money.
So in August, Lordstown announced it intended to go public through a merger with a special purpose acquisition company. And investor sentiment around the company soared, lifted, like many others in the EV market, by a wave of investors on the hunt for the next Tesla.
But also partly because the company said it had around 27,000 pre-orders, plus $75 million of investment from GM.
The financing that comes from being publicly listed is the last piece we needed as we march towards production in 2021.
But Lordstown's ride was about to get a lot bumpier.
In the early hours of January 13th, 2021, an Endurance caught fire on a road in Michigan while being tested by Lordstown engineers. Lordstown said the fire was due to non-conforming parts on the prototype battery. And before long, the company's share price began to tumble. Around that time, several top executives at Lordstown sold off chunks of their own stock, though the company later concluded there was no wrongdoing and that the sales were made for reasons unrelated to the performance of the company. Then came the bidding for a United States Postal Service contract for a fleet of new electric vehicles.
Now, Lordstown hadn't submitted a bid to design and build those trucks, but remember Workhorse? Well, it had, and it was expected to manufacture those trucks in Lordstown's factory. But then...
Oshkosh Defense of Oshkosh, Wisconsin has been awarded the production contract for the Postal Service's next generation delivery vehicles.
Workhorse didn't win, and Lordstown's shares tumbled further.
But it still had further to fall.
In March, shortseller Hindenburg Research accused Lordstown of misleading investors on, among other things, how firm its pre-orders were, saying that many of them were largely fictitious. The report led to a Securities and Exchange Commission inquiry, and later a Justice Department investigation. And although then-CEO Steve Burns told WSJ in March 2021 that the report contained half-truths and lies and denied misrepresenting the order book, he eventually resigned after a board committee found inaccuracies in the company's pre-orders. I tried to reach Burns for comment, but I was unable to do so.
Finally, by the middle of 2021, the company announced that it didn't have enough funds to begin full commercial production. Lordstown needed money. Fast.
Enter Foxconn. Yep, the Taiwanese iPhone manufacturer. The company had said it had ambitions to assemble EVs for a variety of customers on a contract basis, much like it does with its phones.
Foxconn wanted a factory and Lordstown needed capital, so the two companies struck an agreement.
Lordstown would sell its namesake factory to Foxconn for $230 million, and Foxconn would build Lordstown's vehicle.
That was the plan anyway.
Production finally started for a while, and then stopped again shortly after, when the company found a problem with some of its electrical connectors.
We filed paperwork with the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration to voluntarily recall the Endurance.
Lordstown recalled all vehicles that were out in the wild, all 19 of them.
And shortly after, the company's share price, which at one point had been over $30, fell below $1 and stayed there for more than 30 days, triggering a delisting notice from NASDAQ.
That led to Foxconn saying that Lordstown had breached its agreement and that Foxconn would back out of the deal if the matter wasn't resolved.
To try and fix the issue, Lordstown announced that it was doing a reverse stock split, merging 15 shares into one to try and raise the price above $1.
Oh, and just before all that happened, another Lordstown vehicle caught fire, this time a test vehicle in storage. Lordstown said it would investigate the cause.
All that brings us to the present day. Lordstown has said it hopes its reverse stock split will lead to Foxconn returning to the deal. If Foxconn does, then there may be hope for the Endurance yet. But if it doesn't, and Lordstown can't find other funding, the company says it may seek to file for bankruptcy protection. I spoke to Foxconn and Lordstown, but neither would comment on the deal.
But within its SEC filings lies another big hurdle.
Lordstown says the cost to build the Endurance is currently and expected to continue to be substantially higher than its selling price.
And that makes what happens next for Lordstown even more challenging.
In the 3 years that the company has been navigating its various production woes, others, including Ford and Rivian, have been delivering their EV pickups to customers. And more trucks, among them the Chevy Silverado EV, are on the way.
And with the cheapest Silverado set to be around $20,000 cheaper than the Endurance, not only has Lordstown lost the race to be first, but it may now struggle to compete altogether.